Welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays and the 32nd episode in the Building Marble Machine X series, where I'm trying to build a functional marble machine. Let's recap the situation by making a little bit of a to-do list of what remains to be done in the design. We have the treadle pedal, we have the bottom levers, we have the marble funnels, we have instrument holders, we have the demagnetization marble route, the top marble lift, marble drop-off points, top levers, actual lifting fingers, and all connecting marble tracks. In this episode, I'm going to attack the treadle pedal, the demagnetization marble route, and the top marble lift. For each and one of these three designs, I made a crude real-world prototype to test the real-world physics before I started to CAD the actual part. To get the right feel of the treadle pedal, the real-world prototyping is so much more efficient and rewarding than guesswork in CAD. So I just took three wooden boards and I screwed them together with screws, and I could just move these screws around and change to three pivot points and immediately get different results, which I could feel how it felt in the foot. So the first thing to see with this solution is that I love this movement. I think it looks beautiful. It's quite high for the foot here. So maybe this 75 millimeter up here has to be reduced. Let's try 30. Okay. It's difficult to get up in tempo. Gonna move this joint. 75 was too big, and 30 was too small, and 50 was too big. But this is 40 millimeter offset at the center here, and this feels quite good. So I changed the geometry by moving this pivot point down and the pedal closer to the floor, and 40 millimeters, and this feels very promising. I can play faster now. The last test, I moved this joint all the way down that I could right now, and that's so much better. So now it gets really better and better. I'm trying to hit 200 BPM. This really works. When I had my results, I could start to CAD the actual part. Since I'm used to working with plywood, I have to be very careful to not oversize stuff when I design in steel. I'm using 4 millimeter thick steel sheets here that is going to be water cut. And for all these moving parts, it's really important that they are stiff enough and that they hold up for the force of my entire body pedaling this thing. But it's also really important that they don't weigh too much. And since they are going to move up and down for every stroke, you don't want to move around several kilos of metal here. So it's really this design compromise between lightweight and durability that I'm going for here. Next part is the demagnetization route, and I was worried with the first demagnetizer wheel that the marbles were passing the wheel too quickly. I felt that the marbles didn't become completely demagnetized, so I was thinking first that I could turn the magnets that are actually lifting the marbles into a demagnetizer themselves by putting the polarities in opposite directions, and then having the marbles slow down inside the lifting wheel with the brake, and then becoming demagnetized by the same wheel that actually magnetized them. I think actually that's a plausible solution, but I figured something much simpler out. I thought that if I can find a way to break the marbles just on top of the demagnetizer wheel, and then I realized that I needed to divide the marbles up on four anyway for the next lift. So what I did was this very, very simple way of
dividing the marbles onto four channels. The marbles come in from the left and they will choose the lanes of least resistance. So the marbles themselves will choose to go where there's less marbles. You could do this with a flip-flop system, but that has other kind of implications, so that was not really a good solution here. But as you can see, when I keep pushing marbles in from the left, they divide themselves almost with pinpoint accuracy equally over the four lanes.
So you can see on the way how the prototype is built here that this prototype favorizes the outer channels because there's less friction for a marble to just move straight out here than to actually make a turn and go into the middle lanes. So the prototype is biased towards the outer tracks, and that's why we have slightly more marbles in the outer tracks.
So I CADded this thing out, and it's a 3D printed object. The marbles will exit the second marble ring lift from the ring gear of the planetary gear set. They will be pushed over this level surface by the force of the magnets in the lifting wheel, and they will be slowed down to 25% of the speed right above this brand new demagnetizing wheel. So the marbles will also be demagnetized first here and then another time here, where they will slowly creep over the demagnetization place. And the magnets in the new demag wheel is much stronger, and I am really happy with this space efficient solution, and I'm sure this demag marble route will demagnetize the marbles much better than they did before. This design is placed on the left side of the marble machine. You know, when you take a selfie, you always have like this side of your face that you will point to the camera because you think you look better from that angle. This side is that face for the Marble Machine X. So when I'm designing mechanical solutions for this more important vein left side of the Marble Machine X, I'm allowing myself to obsess about aesthetics much more. And that was really the case for the top marble lifting system. So the question was to how to lift the marbles the last 30%, and I thought I was going to make the fish stare, but I realized that the 8 marbles per crank turn capacity would create a very ugly looking fish stare, very broad ugly looking fish stare. Then I came up with this belt cage system, a little reminiscent of the first marble machine. But I ditched that because it looked so bulky. It would have looked super cool in action because it's powered by the piston, so the cage would have stopped loading marbles and like stop, load, go, stop, load, go, stop. It would go in increments like that. But it's way too violent to load 8 marbles per crank turn. It's just not fast enough. Instead, I came up with this, a ratchet lifting system. This system really have the ability to lift 8 marbles per crank turn, and I made a prototype again. I started with modeling the pistons and modeling the linear bearings where the pistons attach. I just want to show you a quick example here on how my CAD skills have improved. I've built these whole pistons with like 100 components in a way that I can just go back to the first sketch and change the length of the piston and all the components will follow. So if I go in here and change the value and make the piston short, all screws, all bearings, all bearing plates and all will just follow and adapt to the new length I put in. The pistons power the marble recycling fish stair on the right side here, and on the left the pistons power the ratchet system. I think that this system is mechanically a little bit more advanced, but will be fast and quick and will not make a giant strange ear on the vain beauty side of the Marble Machine X. And as I said, I've been obsessing about this left side a lot because I know that I want it to look magical and I know that it needs a lot of functionality at a very small space. And there are a lot of design limitations involved in reaching this. So I've been obsessing about this last lift system maybe for 6 months or something. And I think in the Ratchet system that we have a clear winner. So very excited to continue CAD that solution immediately after uploading this video. Okay, that's all for this week's episode. I'm cracking on with the CAD. I wish you all a very, very good day and see you on the next Wintergatan Wednesday. Take care, bye.